Stoichiometry is a kind of calculation in chemistry. It's sort of like bookkeeping. Stoichiometry lets you figure out how much of a substance is used up or produced in a chemical reaction. You need two things to do stoichiometry. One, a balanced chemical equation. Balanced is absolutely essential here. And two, some measured values, the amount of some of the chemicals involved in the reaction. You can use these two things to solve for whatever is unknown, the mass or volume of one of the other chemicals in this balanced chemical equation. It's really common to measure the amount of one reactant in order to figure out how much product you expect to get. Or, given how much of one reactant you have, you might want to figure out how much of a second reactant to add so you don't have any left over. Stoichiometry works because of the law of conservation of mass. Chemical reactions don't create or destroy matter. So, say you have a certain number of atoms of oxygen at the start of a reaction. You will have the same number of atoms of oxygen at the end of the reaction. You can recombine the atoms with other atoms, but you can't destroy them. And you can't change the atoms into some other kind of atom. The balanced chemical equation tells you how the atoms combine in very definite ratios. It's like a recipe. Let's say you want to make grilled cheese sandwiches. You take two slices of bread and one slice of cheese to make one grilled cheese sandwich. Another way you could say this is for every two pieces of bread, you need one piece of cheese to make one grilled cheese sandwich. Believe it or not, this is just like a balanced chemical equation. When you see the equation N2 plus 3H2 yields 2NH3, it's the same as saying it takes two atoms of nitrogen plus six atoms of hydrogen to make two molecules of NH3. The equation also says one molecule of N2 plus three molecules of H2 produces two molecules of NH3. Another way to read the equation is one mole of N2 plus three moles of H2 yields two moles of NH3. Let's look at our grilled cheese sandwich recipe again. What if I asked if you start with six pieces of bread and assume you have excess cheese, more cheese than you need, how many grilled cheese sandwiches can you make? It's tempting to just solve this in your head, but let's solve it like we would a stoichiometry problem. We can use the recipe to find conversion factors. Remember, conversion factors are ratios that equal one. For every two pieces of bread, you need one piece of cheese. So you can write that as a conversion factor. Two bread over one cheese equals one. Similarly, for every two pieces of bread, you get one grilled cheese sandwich. That conversion factor looks like this. Two bread over one grilled cheese sandwich equals one. And for every one piece of cheese, you get one grilled cheese sandwich. The conversion factor is one cheese over one grilled cheese sandwich equals one. Back to our problem. Write down what you know and what you want to get at the end, and leave a blank space for a conversion factor. Six pieces of bread gives us some number of grilled cheese sandwiches. We want a conversion factor that has pieces of bread and number of grilled cheese sandwiches in it. We'll use the conversion factor 2 bread over 1 grilled cheese sandwich equals 1. But careful, we want our units to cancel. So in this case, we'll invert our conversion factor. That's the great thing about conversion factors. They equal 1, so you can flip them and they'll still equal 1. That's why we can use our conversion factor in either orientation. So we have 6 pieces of bread times 1 grilled cheese sandwich over 2 pieces of bread equals some number of grilled cheese sandwiches. Pieces of bread cancels. 6 over 2 equals 3 grilled cheese sandwiches. I'm sure you could have done this problem in your head, but this is how you'll want to write out all your stoichiometry problems. Always write out your work. That way, you'll never accidentally divide instead of multiplying with a conversion factor. If you write it out, you can see when your units cancel properly. And if you're in a class, you might get partial credit for showing your work. It's just a good habit. Now let's try a stoichiometry problem using a balanced chemical equation. The balanced chemical equation will be just like our recipe. N2 plus 3H2 yields 2NH3. If you start with 10 molecules of N2 and you have an excess of H2, how many molecules of NH3 will you make? It's a good idea to check that your equation is balanced. Count up the number of atoms on each side. On the left, we have 2N and 6H. And on the right, we have 2N and 6H. Okay, it's balanced. If your equation isn't balanced, you have to balance it before you can do anything else, or stoichiometry won't work. It would be like a bad recipe, like trying to make grilled cheese sandwiches and starting with one piece of bread and expecting two pieces of bread to magically show up in your finished sandwich. You can't create bread and cheese out of nothing, and the same goes for your chemical reactions. Remember, we're going to use conversion factors. Start with what you know on the left and what you want to wind up with on the right. 10N2 times some conversion factor equals some number of molecules of NH3 on the right. We get our conversion factors from our balanced chemical equation. The equation tells us for every one molecule of N2, you use 3 molecules of H2 to get 2 molecules of NH3. For this problem, we need a conversion factor with molecules of N2 and molecules of NH3. We can write it like this. 1 molecule of N2 over 2 molecules of NH3 equals 1. Let's put that into our problem. Remember, we need to make sure the units cancel. We want to cancel N2 and wind up with NH3, so we're going to flip our conversion factor. 10N2 times 2NH3 over 1N2 equals the number of molecules of NH3. N2 cancels. 10 times 2 equals 20 molecules of NH3. In this stoichiometry problem, we went from molecules to molecules. It turns out it's the same kind of conversion as going from moles to moles. We could have asked, if you start with 10 moles of N2, how many moles of NH3 will you wind up with? And you'd get 20 moles of NH3. The balanced chemical equation tells you the mole ratios of all the reactants and products in the chemical reaction. It gets a little more complicated when you start talking about mass, going from grams to grams, but the general idea is the same. It will take 3 steps: grams to moles, then moles to moles, and finally, moles to grams. We'll tackle these types of stoichiometry problems in part 2.